Hi everyone, welcome back to JPWHUTV. My name is John, your host as always. I hope you're all doing well. The subject of today's video is discussing West Ham United 2, Newcastle United 0. So as always, let's start off with the team sheet. In goal was Fabianski with the right back of Ryan Fredericks. Ogbonna and Diop making up the centre back pairing. Creswell came in for Ben Johnson. Defensive midfielders of Noble and Rice sitting in front of them, with the midfield three of Snodgrass, Lanzini and Anderson, with Hernandez aka Chicharito up front. On the bench was Adrian, Masuaku, Obiang, Nasri, Antonio, Lucas Perez and Marco Arnautovic. So a couple of changes from the City game. No surprises in any shape or form. I did say in the preview that I didn't think this would be a good game for Hernandez, but I was proven wrong. He played superbly well, especially for what we could see in the second half being down at the Bobby Moore lower. As I said in the preview video, the unveiling of the E-Stand to be called the Billy Bond Stand ceremony took place today. Some very good videos went up before the game. And Alvin Martin introduced the ceremony with Billy Bonds with a very, very short and emotional speech, exactly as I expected it to be. Very, very moving day in terms of that. It was, I'm not going to lie, Billy Bonds, he set me off when I saw how much the emotion was getting to him. As we know from Billy, as Billy Bonds is, he's a very, very humble man and doesn't like to have much attention brought on him. But it was just, it was beautiful to see him. See him very caught up in the moment, and to be smashing the heart all the time. Very, very beautiful thing to see. So let's talk about the game itself. Very interesting start to the first 10, 15 minutes. Newcastle had a good few chances in the first half, but we just seemed to dominate it a lot more. More specifically, the first goal coming on the night, just under the ninth minute. Great corner swept in from Anderson, and Rice jumps up and headers it, as he tried to do against Arsenal the other week, but it just, which it went wide. But this time he was completely on target, and there we go, 1-0 up, and absolutely loving it. Interesting celebration from Rice as well, because he was walking around, running around doing that. So maybe the Geordies were giving him a bit of stick. I don't know. But it was good to see him. You know, he's got two goals for us now, and it's a very, very impressive boy. He's still, he played again. He played superbly well in the game today. Absolutely brilliantly. Hardly anybody put a foot wrong, to be honest with you. They were, Noble got booked. Diop got booked. Creswell got booked. But I don't think anyone else did. No. So there we go. So, you know, but it was. But after it went 1-0, we went 1-0 up. Newcastle got very, very gritty very, very quickly. I was quite surprised at that, to be honest with you. Wasn't expecting them to do that. Really, really wasn't expecting them to do that. The referee seemed to give him a B, quite lenient on a few things. There's a very, very tasty challenges that was going on in the first half from Newcastle. Very, very awful. I don't think out of the first booking, I don't think any of the players around before that booking took place, I don't think any of the players got the ball at all from their challenges for, as far as we're concerned. Could be wrong, but as I say, standing in the Bobby Moore lower, couldn't see a lot of things properly. But you know, I'm sure, guys, if you're in the Trevor Brooking or the Billy Bonds or the West End and Barmies, let me know what was going on in the first half. But some very, very tasty challenges going in, and they did not seem to be getting the ball, and they were very, very lucky to stay on the pitch, from what I understood. But as I say, we were 1-0 up at that point, and the tasty challenges kept coming, which caused a penalty. One of the Newcastle players, I think it was on Anderson, on the 41st minute, and up steps Noble, as he always does, goes to kick the penalty, but the ref blew before he could touch the ball because there was too much encroachment, so all the Newcastle players had to get back. He retook it, and boom, top left corner or top bins, as it's known in the football terms, and that's it. Wallop. There we go, 2-0 on 42 minutes, and we just seem to coast a little bit until the break. Now, coming up after the break, talking about the second half, Newcastle came out all guns blazing, as you'd expect them to do. to be honest with you. Newcastle, as I said, I said they play some very good football, and they do. They did some very good stuff in the midfield. Still a little bit tasty. We seem to sit back and let them have the ball a little bit, which grew more and more from about the 64th, 65th minute, give or take. So at least 15, 20 minutes of Newcastle dominance, let's just say. They didn't really seem to do much with the ball. I mean, in the first half, they did score, but their player was 2 yards offside. It was a concern that we're letting players get into that position, regardless of being onside or offside. That's one thing we need to be really, really working on, especially we've still got Arsenal to play at home, Chelsea to play away, Spurs to play away. If we do stuff like that, and even against Everton at home when we play them, if we do that stuff at home, we're going to concede. And we do that away against the big boys, we're going to concede as well. So we need to be a little bit more sharper. The spacing was better today, really was better. Still a lot of work that needs to be done, as I say. But we seem to step off the pitch in the second half. But just talking about the first half quickly, Creswell did get a bit of an injury in the, I think it was just after we scored. But he couldn't continue, unfortunately. He did play a good while, but he got subbed off in the 34th minute with Arthur Masuaku coming on. And to be honest, Masuaku played well. I've got no concerns on him this game at all. He worries me because he's a defender. He's not a defender, he's a winger. He said it himself numerous times. But he's just... It was good today. He made some good runs, some good challenges. It crossed the ball quite well as well, so he's obviously trying to say, look, Creswell's out now. Give me the shirt for the, or at least give me the starting position. As I say, I think it's a little bit harsh on Ben Johnson him not being in the squad, because it would have been good to see him on the bench, but I understand the reasons why. But as I say, in the second half, Hernandez came off on the 70th minute, and Arnautovic came on in his place, and Noble came off on the 79th minute, and Obiang came on in his place as well. Now, Obiang only really didn't seem to do much. He did one decent cross, but the rest, decent pass, but the rest of it, he doesn't convince me. I know, before anybody jumps on me, I know he's a defensive midfielder, but I think his time's up. I really, really think his time's up. And Arnautovic looked lackluster and pretty much lazy. He did try a couple of things which didn't seem to pull off. But yeah, it was the same thing with Hernandez. He tried. He really, really tried, especially in the second half. Some very good balls coming in. One ball from Lanzini that he absolutely mistimed. But it was a very, very fast pass to him. Hernandez... on both sides. There was a beautiful moment in the second half that before Hernandez came off where he could have scored. Perfect ball. Absolutely perfect ball from Lanzini. Daisy cut right across the box. Hernandez is right in the middle. There's hardly anybody around him. There's no way the keeper's getting to him if he kicks it. But he just watched it roll past. I don't know. Maybe Hernandez hasn't got the confidence back yet. But it could have been 3-0. It really could have been 3-0. And it would have been nice to get a goal from open play, because both of our goals in this game were set pieces. But it's just the way it goes, unfortunately. It really is. I mean, Snodgrass played well, Lanzini played well. He piddled around a little bit towards the end of the game, but we could have had a lot more. We really could have had a lot more if we had that bit more spark in the front pitch. But I'm happy with the result. Very, very happy. The performance was a bit lackluster, as I said, in the second half. We seemed to switch off with 25 minutes to go. And it's just, I don't know, it's just, as I say, we need to step up. We really need to sort ourselves out. We need to be able to play a solid 90 minutes. Fortunately, because Newcastle weren't at it 100%, even though they tried from the start of the second half, they really, really, really went gung-ho and tried to score. It just didn't happen for them. Fabianski made some superb saves, as he always does. The geezer is such a reliable bloke now. He really is a rock. And as a result, I think Adrian's off in the summer because of it. But anyway, guys, those are my thoughts. Thank you very much for your time. If you're new around here and you like what I'm doing, please hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you get first dibs on all the videos. By all means, guys, put your comments in the comment section below. Do you feel anybody had a great performance? Do you feel anybody had a bad performance? Who was your man of the match? I mean, Lanzini got the man of the match, and I'm not 100% sure on that. But it's just, yeah, I mean, it was hard to just... to pick a man of the match today, but for me personally, I can see why Lanzini got it. For me, though, I think Diop was my man of the match. It was very, very good, with Fabianski coming a very, very close second. If you like the video and you feel I deserve it, then by all means, please click the like button. And also, please share this video on any format of social media or communication device that you wish. WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, you name it. Share it if you wish. It'd be great. It'd be great to have some new faces on the channel, making comments and everything. And so, yeah, we go again. We've got Cardiff at the weekend, next weekend. So the preview will be going up on Wednesday for that. So keep an eye out for the video coming up. In the meantime, guys, thank you very much for your time. It really means a lot to me that you've been able to watch this video and put your comments in the comment section. I really love enjoying it. I really love reading some of your comments. It's been brilliant. And also, just enjoy your weekend. And I will see you next week for the Cardiff preview. All the best now. Take care.